We're up here at 4,000 feet with Eric Lentz. EricLentz.ca, right? Yeah. And Eric and I are going to do a little acrobatics in
MDM1 Fox.
MDM1 Fox. And I'm really fortunate because Eric is going to be representing the United States this summer in Poland, an international glider acrobatic competition. And he's going to show me some of his smoothest moves here pretty soon, which we will show if I make it through okay.
MDM1 Fox.
MDM1 Fox. And I'm really fortunate because Eric is going to be representing the United States this summer in Poland, an international glider acrobatic competition. And he's going to show me some of his smoothest moves here pretty soon, which we will show if I make it through okay. You got her.
We'll just show you, we'll just do one aileron roll.
Okay.
And then I'll do another half roll and we'll do a spin from there.
Okay.
We'll do an inverted spin, one turn.
Okay.
Energy pretty good. Spin.
That's awesome, bud. That was a aileron roll and a something or other.
Okay, we'll do a tail slide, and after you do the tail slide, just say your hammerhead with a quarter roll on the upline.
Okay. This is a hammerhead?
This is a tail slide.
Tail slide, this is what I did then. This?
Ooh, a hammerhead here.
Hammerhead, okay. So you just fall off on the left side.
Yep. See the curve right there, and then you think you might see an Immelman.
Yeah.
We'll do an Immelman next.
Needs to be done quickly.
Well, you need to have a roll rate like this thing has. It's pretty tough to do that in a glider that's not meant for aerobatics.
Yeah, well, I was doing it in a jet. Yeah, give me a second here.
Yeah. Good thing.
Okay.
If you feel like you want to fly the airplane, if you feel a little bit dizzy, sometimes flying the airplane yourself makes it better.
I'm okay, I just a little break in the action.
Okay.
Okay, I'm okay.
Okay.
Yep.
We'll do a hammerhead and then we'll do a snap roll going towards the ground. Alright?
Alright.
Kicked late, ended up doing a tail slide.
Okay. You can tell by me.
That's what makes the glider competition fun. The sequences are simpler and things are happening a little bit slower, but when you screw something up in the glider, you don't get away with it. You screw up it.
In a powered plane, sometimes you get away with it?
Oh yeah, you get away with all kinds of things.
Huh. And that's because you have power to recover, to smooth it out or something?
Well, you've got power, you've got a huge roll rate. Everything's a little bit easier for the airplane to do.
Uh-huh.
So we're not doing things as complicated, but we're still doing everything the airplane can do. And we're kind of right at the limit of what the airplane can do as far as, you know, using the energy that you have and
Uh-huh.
and all that.
Okay, that makes sense. But in this you don't have those things.
Yes, if you miss an airspeed or if you do something at the wrong time, it just doesn't work.
Okay. So each one of these maneuvers, you have an entry airspeed that you better hit right on, huh?
Yep. You carry as much energy as you can, but as little energy as you have to.
Sure. And then the G's got to be right on too within a little bit?
I don't pay attention so much to how many G's.
So you just do that on feel then?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's like a hard pull and a soft pull.
Uh-huh.
Let's do a little bell roll here. That's about the prettiest, most benign maneuver you can do.
Say that again?
I think the barrel roll is about the prettiest, most benign maneuver you can do.
You got it. You're right.
You do a couple of those.
Funnest part of the ride.
Yeah, that was it.
That's awesome. A little crosswind, huh? see that little pass?
Yeah.
Oh man.
It sounded like a jet. Going like hell.
160.